the first time I saw the P24 hub, I was a little bit confused. And I've seen people think it's a 4-channel mic preamp. So let's go over what it does, how to set it up, and I can promise you it's a lot easier than you might think. Let's dive right in. You can daisy chain up to 5 P24s to a wing console. So the question is, do I need a P24 hub? And there are a couple points you should keep in mind. The first one is that the P24 can provide remote power to up to 8 P24s connected to the front ports of the hub. The second point is that the P24, besides being compatible with StageConnect, is also compatible with ULTRANET and AS50, making this system compatible with X32, M32, or even P16 systems. And by the way, you can also daisy chain at least 3 P24s, and all of them remain independent from each other and fully functional. Also, the maximum length from the first StageConnect device to the last one should not exceed about 30 meters. And on the P24 hub, that's measured from each of the front ports. If you're connecting the P24 personal mixers to the wing, that distance is measured from the console to the fifth P24. Also, if you're using wireless transmitters, it is really handy to have all these analog outputs so you can have the hub and the transmitters in a single rack. So first, the source selection. You can use the input button to select the source that's gonna feed the P24. And that can be AS50, StageConnect, or ULTRANET. StageConnect and AS50 can work in 16 or 24 channel modes. ULTRANET works only in 16 channel mode. There is an input and an output port for each protocol or client and host for StageConnect. That means you can daisy chain one hub to up to 3 hubs using one of those 3 protocols. You can even mix and match. Let's say right now we're feeding the signal from the console to the hub using AS50, but I could daisy chain the hubs using StageConnect. The StageConnect host is gonna forward the signals that are incoming to the P24 hub, regardless of if they're being sent through StageConnect or AS50 or ULTRANET. Now the THRU button, it has 2 functions. First of all, if you hold it down, the P24s that are connected to the hub are gonna be rescanned. You can do that in case a P24 is not being recognized. And the second function, well, to explain that, we have to keep in mind that each AS50 port has 2 directions, inputs and outputs. And also, whatever is going from the console to the hub, and then from the first hub to a second hub, is labeled downstream. And what's going from the second hub to the first hub, or from the first hub to the console, is labeled upstream. So originally, the AS50A port from the hub to the console consists of the first 16 channels that are the 8 stereo mixes coming from the P24s. And then channels 17 to 48 are channels 1 to 32 coming upstream through the AS50B port. So if you've connected a stage box or a second hub, you can also receive those signals coming from the hub or the stage box on the console. If you press the THRU button, you're gonna get rid of the stereo mixes coming from the P24s. And instead, you're just gonna receive on the console whatever's connected to the AS50B upstream. There are 4 StageConnect ports on the front, and you can connect 2 P24s to each port. Right now, we've connected 2 P24s to the 4th port. And you can see there are LEDs with 2 digits. The first digit indicates the number of the P24 port on the front, and the second digit indicates if the P24 is the first or the second one in the chain. So right now, 4.1 and 4.2 are active. And if I disconnect the second P24 from the chain, 4.2 is going to get red. And if I connect it to the second port, now this P24 becomes the first one in the chain of port 2. You probably will have to rescan the P24s by holding the THRU button, and there you go. You're up and running again. A lot of engineers and bands use wireless in-ear monitoring systems. And if that's the case, you can take the analog outputs from the hub and connect them to the wireless transmitters, which will probably be in a single rack, keeping everything really tidy. In that way, the only cable going from the hub to the stage will be a DMX cable for each P24 mixer. If the engineer needs to listen to the talkback with analog outputs, you can use this switch. And when you activate it, these two ports are going to transmit the two talkback channels instead of the second P24 mix on the fourth hub. So now the question is, can I use an XLR cable or do I have to stick with DMX? Well, the thing is, StageConnect is really sensitive when it comes to cable impedance, and XLR cables can vary wildly. DMX is specified to be from 100 to 120 ohms, and StageConnect really likes 110, so there's a match there. If you're, let's say, in a room and you're only going to use a short run, then XLR cables are fine. But if you want to connect the hub to P24's on-stage longer runs, then better stick to DMX cables. There you have it. There's a P24 hub for a reason. You can remote power the P24 mixers connected to it through the front ports, and the 30 meter range resets itself from each of the front stage connect ports. Also, you can connect signals to the hub using stage connect, but also Ultranet and AS50, making it compatible not only with Wing, but also backwards compatible with M32 and X32. You've also got the analog outputs on each hub, and you can daisy chain multiple hubs, easily getting you up to 24 musicians, each with an individual monitoring mix.